Hey guys, Chris.
Right here looking through the day hog. Wait, that doesn't sound right.
By hog, I mean bass. Largemouth bass.
Trying to get some cool video for a good friend of mine. Can't make it out right now because you know, he's going through a rough time. And I want to get a cool video where we used to fish, you know, one of our spots. Texas Greg, you're just gonna want to bounce this off the bottom, kind of hop it the whole way back to the boat, keeping tension on your line. So braided line is the best for this. You can really feel anything, tink, 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 come on. You can definitely tell the difference between weeds and a bite, 100%. Monofilament, there's like that sponginess, the elasticity to it, so it's a lot harder to get a really good hook stick. Where with braid, there's no sponginess to it, so you get that immediate hook set. Sometimes it can be a good thing, sometimes it can be a bad thing, it's just however you use it, I guess. That means anything. I'm still pissed off because my rod broke. Yeah, that feels better. This is a Joe Worthy fish. Texas rig. Right in our old spot, Joe. Yeah. Hopefully this rod holds up. Doesn't break like my other one. Oh, buddy, Joe, this is a good one, brother. Oh, Joey, this is a good one, bro. This is a good one, Joe. Son of a bitch, another broken rod. But would you look at that? It's finally a Joe-worthy fish. Yeah, buddy. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. That's worth it. I broke two rods today. Woo. Boo. Totally worth it. Yes. God, I'm so glad. Finally got a good fish worthy of my buddy Joe. Oh, thank you, Creator. Yeah, that's for you, Joe. We love you, brother. Oh, God. Oh, thank God. Oh, my God.